Currently, I teach at the University of Nairobi. I'm a lecturer in the Department of Civil and Construction Engineering. My line of specialization is structural engineering. I have done research on cement, and in particular, bagasse ash. Bagasse ash is a ash that is gotten from sugarcane fibers. When you burn that, you get bagasse ash. And the findings that we got was that bagasse ash is good for concrete. One, it improves the durability of concrete by reducing the size of pores, you know, in concrete. And two, at some small percentage, the strength of concrete is actually enhanced when you put some bit of bagasse ash together with alongside cement. Why I set out to look at bagasse ash is because we have significant amounts of sugarcane and sugar processing in this country. Some factories, after extracting the sugar and the other byproducts, they burn the bagasse to produce electricity, and then the resulting ash becomes almost a waste. And therefore, we thought of using that to see if we can do some value addition to the ash, and. We found very interesting results. Research at PhD level requires a lot more than what we have currently at the University of Nairobi. And I had a blessing of being a part of a network called AMSEN. AMSEN, which is part of RISE, paid for my PhD research. They gave me a scholarship for the PhD. You know, PhD opportunities are available. But PhD opportunities that you do your research in your home country, usually they are not very many. So, you know, RISE provided that opportunity that I could do my PhD here in my home country. And of course, then there was the advantage that I didn't lose touch with the industry. You know, as I was doing my research, I was also able to teach a bit and to do some bit of consultancy as well. I think is a wonderful experience, is excellent opportunity that it provided on several fronts. One is the access to other institutions and whatever equipment that they have for research. The equipment that we use is expensive, it's very expensive, and sometimes it's difficult to find all of it in one institution. So the idea of pooling equipment, you know, bringing together several universities and sharing the equipment is an excellent one, because it enables students like the way I was to access such equipment at a fairly lower cost. The other thing that I saw was a great advantage was the networking with other researchers in the particular areas of study. For example, I had access to a professor of material science from the University of Namibia, and of course also students, PhD students, MSc students that we got to interact, you know, in conferences and stuff like that. It was a really enriching experience. To have funding is one thing. To have access to the right equipment is a totally different thing. Were it not for the network that I got to study in, you know, it would have been a big challenge, you know, because if I am to go into another institution to do any tests there, you know, there's a lot of bureaucracy between this university where I'm studying and the other university. But when there is already a working relationship, a lot of that bureaucracy is removed, so a lot of time is saved, and I think that's a big challenge. Of course, the other thing that I found to be a challenge is if you have to work as you try to research, as you try to study, it also becomes a big challenge. Of course, the working takes a center stage, or becomes more important, and then you slow down on the research. New knowledge in science, sometimes it requires a bit of time to incorporate into society as an end product, the scientist needs to push out the information to the industry and by extension to the public, but also the industry needs to be willing to take in the new information. And it boils down to how closely the universities work with the industry. There is some linkage, but my opinion is not sufficient. Part of my career now will have to be in concrete research. As you know, teaching at the university, you need to be doing research. Otherwise, then you become irrelevant very quickly. So what I'm looking at in the future is to continue doing research, preferably in concrete, and of course to practice structural engineering, because the researcher has got to address the problems of the industry, and you wouldn't know the problems of the industry if you're not part of the industry. So I'm trying to push both of them, both the practice, you know, to try and do some consultancy, and to also try and push the research.
As a person who did his PhD, what would be your word to somebody out there or another student who would wish to follow your footsteps?
Pursue it. It's doable. It can be done here. The opportunities are there for PhDs. If somebody is interested, if they look for those opportunities, they are available. They can get opportunities. And this country needs that level of skill.